Hello, I hope you guys are all doing great. This is the nail art design we're going to be working on today. We're going to be creating a marble effect, and then on our thumb and on our ring finger, we'll be painting a flower. Let's get started. The first thing to do is apply a background color. The one I chose for my background is this one by Wet n Wild, and it's called Extravaganza. Followed by that, we're going to be creating a wide side swipe. Once your background is completely dry, it's time to go in and create the marble effect. I'm going to be using water-based acrylic paints, but do keep in mind that nail polish will work just as fine. I'm going to be using this one, it's called Cranberry Wine, and I'm also going to be using a regular white one. The tool I'm going to be using, you can either go in with a marbling tool, but I'm going to be using a brush. So let's get started. I'm going to go move into my white color, and I'm just going to begin overlapping some of the burgundy ones. And if you use nail polish, I would actually think it's better because the color stays wet a lot longer. I'm going to go in with my brush, and I'm just going to begin swirling it around. And you don't want to do the areas too long. You don't want to do them too much because then it'll turn muddy, and you don't want your marble to look muddy. So to bring it out to the corner, you can just go ahead and swerve it to the corners, just like that. And go into this side and just swerve it around. I'm gonna bring this one out a little bit. Once your marbling is completely dry, it's time to go in with a silver, but this step is optional. I'm going to be using this one. It's by Folk Art and it's silver. I'm going to show you how it looks on the little plate. It's completely opaque and you can't even see the glitters, but it dries clear and it just gives a really nice effect. So I'm going to be applying that. So I'm just going to be swerving that around everywhere, and you can see there that it looks opaque. But don't worry, it'll dry clear. So I'm just swerving this over the entire thing. I'm just going to go all around, swerving those areas. Now just allow it to dry. You can see there the glitter has dried clear. Next thing to do is I'm going to go over my side swipe, and I'm going to be applying 1mm size silver rhinestones, just outlining my side swipe. I'm going to be applying top coat over my side swipe to make it nice and sticky so the rhinestones can stay on nicely. And I'm just going to begin from this very corner here, and I'm just going to start applying the rhinestones. And I want to leave enough space in between so that I can place one bead in between each rhinestone. So I'm leaving some space. Now I'm going in between and I'm going to be placing one bead in the center of each of my rhinestones. This is the design I have over all my nails, so you'd basically be done. But I decided to add a flower on my ring finger along with on my thumb. So it's up to you to decide if you're going to want to do that. So let's move over to that step. This is the brand and size brush I'm going to be using to go in and create my flower. I'm going to go in with the silver again, and I'm going to be painting the center of my flowers with the silver glitter. I'll be placing some clear polish in the center of my flower, and I'm going to pick a rhinestone. I'm going to be using the same exact size I used to outline my side swipe. And there we have the flower. And your last step is to apply your top coat over your entire design, sealing it in nicely. Always remembering to do your nails free edge. And that's it. That's how you're going to get this nail art design done. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and try out this nail art using your favorite colors. Be safe, and I'll see you next time. Bye!